Right, all right, all right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Man, thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, West Coast, baby. Let's get it in. This one's talking about, though, college football. Excuse me. The Big Four team announcement is happening tomorrow. ESPN is milking some more advertising dollar out of their budget. Man, oh man, oh man, what a sham that show is. Holy crap. Just give us the information at the end of the year. We all know that this thing figures itself out by the end of the year, right? Who's in the top four, okay? Again, my pick is six teams. Six. Top two, bye week. Don't have to add much more games. Every conference championship, everybody gets a win. Top five are in. You get one extra. Simple. Done. Notre Dame's in. Five conference champions. Notre Dame's not in. Extra SEC team. Whatever. Let's talk about it, shall we? I love to talk about by this point in the year. This is going to be Halloween tomorrow. Happy Halloween, everybody. By this point in the year, I think everybody should know what your top two teams are in each league. Okay? Or each division of each, you know, thing. So, let's start with the SEC. Alabama always, every time, is the best, right? For the last, like, 10 years, Alabama's been kicking butt. But this year, Georgia's awesome. Georgia's right there in the number two seed. Somebody's going to win or lose this game because of the SEC championship. But does the loser still get in the four-teamer? Good question. Would they get in as the fourth team and have to play the number one team again? If Alabama's number one team, Georgia goes number three, that'd be crazy if Georgia lost. Okay? Alabama doesn't really care if they lose. If they lose, they're still in. They could almost lose two games, it feels like, and they'd still be in. It's crazy people have the love affair with Alabama. Georgia, if they lose, they're out. They're like number 10 or something. Ohio State's in. Ohio State's got that cachet, got that name. Lost early, lost bad. Oklahoma. But lost early, right? People love that. Wisconsin. Somebody's got to come out of the Big Ten. The Big Ten and the SEC are the two best conferences in football right now. Somebody's got to come out of the Big Ten. I think at this point it's going to be hard to say that with a four-team playoff, you're going to have two teams from any division. But this year, what if it was two teams from the Big Ten, two teams from the SEC, and Pac-12, ACC, and Big 12 were all left out. Crazy. It could happen. You never know. Notre Dame. Notre Dame's really interesting because if they win out, they do have a pretty tough schedule. They play that independent ACC blend, but they got a pretty tough schedule, so I wouldn't put it past them. And then Clemson, with their loss, is on the kind of outside looking in. Then you've got Penn State, then you've got Oklahoma, then you've got Miami, then you've got TCU, then you've got Oklahoma State, then you've got Washington. I tend to think a Pac-12 school, if they do run the table from this point out, only have one loss, will be in there. If it's SC, SC's not going to be in it. If it's Washington with one loss, I think they're in it. SC just getting hammered by Notre Dame is just no bueno by any stretch of the imagination. And, you know, that's just one of those tough situations for them. Like, they were in it. They had the situation right there, ready for the taking. But now they've got two losses. They can't do it now. It's up to Washington to try to carry the torch. And hopefully they can. I mean, Washington's one of those teams that's really kind of strange, you know, when Washington is playing really well. Washington, I think, is the best team in the conference. But when Washington isn't playing well, you know what, man? Washington is one of those teams. They looked terrible against Cal. So they're one of those teams that could really lay an egg. And if they do lay an egg, you know, at this point in the game, you're out. You cannot go in with two losses. The only way you're even getting a chance to get in there is with one loss. So let's talk about it a little bit. Okay. Alabama plays LSU. I don't think LSU gives Bama that much of a run. Early in the year, maybe it looked like it. Ed Orgeron, it felt like the buzz was back. Everything was rolling. But at this point, Bama's going to roll all the way until they get to Georgia in that SEC championship. Now, Georgia beat Florida, and that was a big game because, you know, that Georgia-Florida game is always the big one. You know, I heard they went PC on this one and changed the name from the biggest outdoor cocktail party to, like, the biggest college football party or some sort of weird thing. Or maybe not even a party, outdoor gathering or some sort of weird deal. Ohio State beats Penn State, game of the week. Had to have this win if you're Ohio State. Last year, Penn State beats Ohio State. This year, Ohio State beats Penn State. This exact same scenario could happen. What if Penn State runs the table? What if they're in a situation just like Ohio State was in last year where they're the best one-loss team in the Big Ten? You never know. Ohio State, I think, is going to be there. I think they're going to be there right at the end. I know they have a bad loss early on, but the team they lost to is still in the top 10, so I don't think that's that bad of a loss. Wisconsin, I think, will lose at some point. I'm just not impressed, really, with their offense. Yes, they can score points, but, you know, last week only beating Illinois 24-10. That's a little tough. Notre Dame's the interesting one because Notre Dame's got really good defense right now, and they can run the ball. They got that huge offensive line. Notre Dame's really interesting to me. Notre Dame just crushes SC, and SC looks good to me besides that Notre Dame game. They've still got Stanford. If they play Stanford without Bryce Love, then that's going to be an interesting game for Notre Dame. So I think everything goes for them. They play Wake Forest. I think that's a win. Clemson, Penn State, Oklahoma, all really interesting teams. And there's Miami. Miami at 7 wins. Really being underestimated. The U. Imagine the U being underestimated. Imagine the U not really given respect. I don't think they went out, but, dude, the U is back, man. Mark Richt, dude, that's awesome. And then TCU with the horrible loss, man, at Ames. You know, it's always tough to play at Ames. You know, 7-14, that's how they do it up there. You know, they play Texas. What if Texas beats TCU this week and you lose 2 in a row? The dream's over there. Oh, man, so quickly. Oklahoma State, they play Oklahoma this weekend. This is going to be a huge game. This is probably going to be the one that decides this bad boy. Even though you do have other representation in the Big 12, Oklahoma and TCU, I think, are the top dogs there. When you look at the Big 12, you know, every year it feels like they're so close, and then something happens. You know, now they've got this Big 12 championship game they added to it, and I think that's a bad move because you're going to get another loss from somebody. Somebody's going to lose in that game. Somebody's going to have an opportunity to go to the 14 playoff, and then they're going to lose in that bad boy. It happens every year. Virginia Tech is rolling. They got one loss, and they're playing Miami. So here's a big showdown for the ACC. If Miami can win out, I think Miami puts a lot of pressure on the committee to put them in there, or at least get them into the ACC championship game, right? Ohio State's rolling. Why not Ohio State, you know? Let them go. And then the craziest is UCF. Scott Frost, got to tip your cap. A lot of Oregon Duck fans wanted Frost to come out here. It didn't happen. Man, oh, man, oh, man, they're rolling. And then Southern California plays Arizona. Wouldn't be surprised if Arizona beat Southern California. So, again, crazy stuff's happening out here. That's why you play the game. Stanford played Washington State, and Washington State might beat Stanford. The Pac-12 is just crazy, crazy stuff out here. So good times to be a college football fan. Good times to be a sport fan, man. Watch the World Series. The World Series is off the chain right now. You got college football. You got the NFLs doing well. Man, it is just awesome. NBA just got back from the Blazer game tonight, so good things are happening. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Check out any of the videos if you got some time, man. Adios.